यस अनंत,
गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन. आई थिंक वी विल वेट फॉर 5 मिनट्स फॉर पीपल टू जॉइन. पीपल आर स्टिल जॉइनिंग. वी विल स्टार्ट द सेशन इन 2 मिनट्स, राइट हार्दिक सर?
यस यस
जतिन सर, वी विल टेक 2 मिनट्स, लेट पीपल, लेट ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स कम.
So good evening, everyone. Before we move ahead towards our today's presentation, I would request everyone to please subscribe on Ishre Ahmedabad chapter's YouTube page. We are posting all the videos of Ishre 1 degree challenge, Ishre Ahmedabad 1 degree challenge, and all the activities of Ishre Ahmedabad chapter. So would request everyone, please like FB page of Ishre Ahmedabad chapter. We are on Instagram also. You can like us on LinkedIn and Twitter also. But before that, I'll definitely request you, please subscribe on Ishre YouTube page, Ishre Ahmedabad chapter YouTube page. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Sneh. I think we will start. So a warm welcome to all the participants and all the panelists present. On behalf of student activities team, I welcome everyone on the webinar on analysis of absorption cooling system, an engineering equation solver based approach. To conduct this today, we have with us this evening Dr. Jatin Patel sir. Dr. Jatin Patel sir is currently serving as an assistant professor in mechanical engineering department at Pandit Deen Dayal Petroleum University PDPU. Also, he is a faculty coordinator at ISHRE PDPU chapter since last 5 years, and he has been a great support to ISHRE Ahmedabad chapter student activities team and especially Hardik sir, because of the he received project grant of almost 3 lakh rupees. Throughout his rich experience of more than 15 years, he has published more than 30 papers and is presently involved in research work towards the thermodynamic analysis of cooling system, solar collectors, water purification system using sustainable energy and solar drying systems. So over to you, Jatin sir, please carry on the session. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Anand. Hello everyone, good evening. Today the topic of the webinar, that is analysis of absorption cooling system and engineering equation solver approach. So the sole purpose of this webinar is to introduce one of the software tool, which is engineering equation solver for analyzing any type of thermal system. Here, I'm going to take the example of absorption cooling system, how the absorption cooling system can be analyzed using the engineering equation solver. Now, this is useful for the students, faculty members, as well as researchers. For faculty members, generally, as a faculty member, we are facing the problems in the class to solve the numericals, which is having some complex calculation procedure. Sometimes the calculation procedure also time consuming. So we may ignore that particular complex calculations in the class, as well as a faculty member, we are not giving such examples as an assignment to the students. And for students also, sometimes the repeated or iterative calculation that is laborious. So students are also not preferred to do that type of calculations. But in actual practice, the thermodynamic, whenever for actual system is to be analyzed, okay, as a student or as a faculty member or as a researcher, okay, we have to come across this type of complex thermodynamic calculations. So considering the audience of students, faculty members, and the researchers, let me start this webinar. About my university, I am a faculty member in mechanical department at Pandit Dindayal Petroleum University. This university is NAC accredited, and I'm from mechanical department, which is NB accredited. And our university is offering programs in the various domains, science, technology, management, and humanities. And in mechanical department, BTech, MTech, and PhD programs are offered with the thrust in industry and research cultures. Now coming to the topic, vapor absorption cooling system. Nowadays, if you observe, for cooling on larger scale, people are using the absorption cooling system, means they prefer absorption cooling system. The reason I have mentioned over here, some benefits of absorption cooling systems I have listed out. The first one, that is lower running cost. Now the reason is, to run vapor absorption system, the heat is required, not the electricity. And when the heat is used, and the heat which is required in absorption cooling system, that is in the temperature range of about 70 to 120 degrees Celsius. So if any industry is having the waste heat available in this range, it is more than sufficient to run this absorption cooling system. So the waste heat, there are lots of opportunities of availability of the waste heat in industrial processes. So if we use the waste heat for working the vapor absorption system, which is otherwise going to waste, we can increase the energy recovery ratio. And by that way, the cheap cooling that is possible. Now, when we talk about the waste heat, not always the industrial waste heat, But solar thermal energy can also be used. Solar thermal energy, which is available in this temperature range, that can be integrated with the vapor absorption. So solar collector can be integrated with the vapor absorption system to make the system more sustainable. And the last one, that is refrigerant, which are used in the vapor absorption cooling, which are having very low carbon footprint when we are comparing with the compression refrigeration system. So with these benefits, people are preferring the absorption cooling systems. Now here, we would like to discuss about the analysis, thermodynamic analysis. Now, whenever any system is to be analyzed thermodynamically, second law analysis or exergy analysis is preferred. Now this exergy analysis, that is very useful tool to improve the design, to improve the energy efficiency, to address the environmental performance aspects, economics, and some other factors that can be easily means analyzed with this exergy tool. Now, what is exergy? The students or researchers or faculty members who are in the field of thermal engineering, okay, they are aware about exergy. So by definition, exergy, that is useful work, maximum useful work, which can be extracted from the system as it reversibility come into equilibrium with its environment. Very simple example, let me give you. Suppose you have the steam at temperature of 200 degrees Celsius and pressure, let's say 30 bar. And if that steam is expanded through a turbine in a reversible way, in a such a way that at the exit of the turbine, the steam temperature and pressure becomes the or equivalent to the environment temperature. So in that case, during that expansion process, whatsoever work delivered by the turbine, okay, that we can say that is exergy. So in short, exergy, that is the potential of available energy to produce the work, that is exergy. So primary aim of exergy analysis is usually to provide the meaningful efficiencies and the factors, okay, which affects this efficiency, okay, and how to overcome that, okay, that will be main purpose to carry out the exergy analysis. Now, briefly, let me explain the exergy analysis method. In a red box, you can see the system. You can consider system, let's say, generator of the vapor absorption system. That is one of the system. Now, for that particular system, the energy can be transferred through heat, mass, and work. These are the three ways by which the energy can transfer. So whenever mass is transferring through the system, the potential available with the mass, which is flowing, let's say at m dot or m dot kg per second. So in terms of kilojoule per kg, I can define the potential of the flow as H minus S0 minus T0 S minus S0. Here the property with zero subscript that denotes the properties of the substance which is possessing some energy at dead state or environment state. Similarly, exergy of the heat. So energy can be transferred through heat. So exergy of the heat, that is given as 1 minus T0 by T into delta Q, where delta Q is the amount of heat transfer takes place at particular temperature T. Correct. So whenever Q is transferring, okay, I can say that EXQ, which is the exergy of that particular Q, is transferring. And whatever work is given, whenever a system is given the work or system delivers the work, the exergy associated with the work is work itself. So if I apply the exergy balance for this particular system, which is nothing but exergy in minus exergy out, and whenever there is no any irreversibility during any thermal process, then there is no any loss of work potential. So in that case, exergy in minus exergy out, that is change in exergy of the system. But as we know that the thermodynamic processes are not reversible. So due to the irreversibility, some of the work potential that is utilized to overcome that disturbances, which is known as exergy destruction. So exergy destruction from the energy balance for a steady flow can be given by this equation. So here delta psi, that is the exergy destroyed, that is equal to exergy change or exergy transfer by mass, exergy transfer by heat, and exergy transfer by work. So whatsoever component you are considering for exergy analysis, you require the initial state and final state. If you have the initial state and final state, you can easily write this exergy balance equation, and you can define the exergy destruction in that particular component during the thermal process. Now here, absorption cycle schematic that you can see. Here are four major components. Let me explain the working in very briefly. So generator, condenser, evaporator, and absorber, these are the four main components. In the generator, the weak solution of absorber and absorbent that is heated with the thermal source and refrigerant that is evaporated and condensed into the condenser. Again, sink is used. Now that condensed refrigerant is expanded to the expansion valve, and in the evaporator it produces a cooling effect. And that refrigerant, again, that is absorbed by the strong solution, which is coming from the generator to the absorber. And again, that weak solution is moved back to the generator. Correct. So during absorption process, heat will be generated. So that heat is to be removed through the any cooling medium. In the condenser also, the refrigerant that is condensed, so that latent heat that is removed by the cooling water. So generally absorber and condenser are operating at the same temperature. Evaporator and generator temperature, which are evaporator is user defined, and generator temperature depends upon the type of waste heat available. So here you can see total 8 state points are there. Suppose I want to carry out the exergy analysis of each and every components. Okay, the state points, let's say for generator, I must require the properties at state point 11, 12, 3 and 4. Okay, if I have this, easily I can carry out the exergy balance and I can find out the exergy loss into the generator. Similarly in all the components. Now in a thermodynamic formulation, certain assumptions are made. Let's say absorption system is analyzed in the steady state condition. Second, along with the working fluid flow, pressure drop and heat losses or gains to the ambient are negligible. Refrigerant condenses inside the condenser and leaves as a saturated liquid and exits the evaporator as dry saturated vapor. This is assumption. And the expansion valves are considered isenthalpic. So with this assumption, if I apply the exergy balance, these equations I can derive. So these are the equations of exergy losses across various components of the vapor absorption system. Now this equation looks nice, but when you solve it using a black and white paper and using the property table, it takes lots of time. And again, if you want to carry out the parametric analysis, so you can solve all these equations for one particular operating condition. If operating condition changes, if the generator temperature is changes from let's say 70 to 75 degrees Celsius, entire calculations needs to be repeated. So this is very, you know, tedious process. So it is observed that absorption cycles are difficult to model because they are described by a large set of equations which may be having the non-linear characteristics. So it is difficult to solve all this equation at a time, but these problems, okay, can be solved using the engineering equation solver. Okay, we can also use the MATLAB, but here how the ES, that is very much useful, especially for thermal process that we'll see in the next slides. Now it EES provides the large bank of high accuracy thermodynamic and transport property data and library of heat transfer functions. So these are inbuilt within this EES, okay, which is otherwise not available with any other software tool. Now, in addition, the simulation results can be used to generate plots, and whatsoever plots can be generated using this EES, which are having resolution and the nature of plots are equivalent to the plots which are generally found into the research papers. And also here, the sophisticated optimization algorithms can also be integrated to optimize the operating parameters. So here, what is EES? Some of you may be familiar with this word EES, which is pronounced as AIS. So it is a general purpose equation solver, modeling and analysis tool, which has started life specially for the purpose of engineering education. So Professor Klein of Department of Mechanical Engineering, University of Wisconsin Madison, has used this software for education purpose. Then after, it is more popular into the research communities. So it is quite capable and more than adequate for engineering education purpose. Students, researchers, and teachers find it far easier. This is my experience that when I have started the use of engineering equation solver, okay, I can easily program or easily model any thermodynamic or any thermal processes. So as compared to Mathematica, MATLAB, or MathCAD, okay, it is far, far easier. Anyone can learn it and anyone can model the system using the EES. Advantages, it requires no real programming. Generally, especially for mechanical engineer, programming that is somewhat tedious job. So here in EES, it requires no real programming. The way you are writing the equations in your notebook, similar way you have to write down the equations into the program window that I'll show you. Then equations. So here, whenever we are modeling any thermodynamic process, number of equations you derive. So when all these equations are to be solved, you are not supposed to maintain the order of the equation. So in any order, equations can be typed or entered into the program. It is geared towards engineering problems. Units enables and unit conversion routines are possible. So in any unit, okay, the problem is formulated, okay, that can be solved. Formatted equations, when you write the equations, okay, that can be formatted with the Greek letters, which is sometimes useful to use it during the report writing of the modeling procedure you are working on. Lots of online example problems that is available. So in the corner of world, anywhere you sit, okay, without the help of anyone, okay, you can work with the EES. Lots of online examples, programs are given, small programs are given. Through that, you can learn the process, okay, how to solve your problem. Excellent online help and online manual is there. So these are the advantages, some features. So excellent engineering features. It has lookup tables and regression analysis that is possible. Plots and overlay plots easily you can do. Diagram window, you can prepare the diagrams. You can prepare the animation, especially for teachers. Suppose you want to show the animation of any thermal process. Okay, you can prepare the animation using the EES. Built-in property library in which thermophysical properties are available. So you name the material, you name the fluid, the properties are available with the EES. So every year the EES software is updated and new properties which are invented, okay, that is incorporated into that. So you will be rich of thermodynamic property or thermophysical properties into the EES. And predefined constants already there, let's say sigma value, let's say gravitational constant values. So all these constants are already predefined, and it is having analysis features, parametric study, uncertainty, propagation, and minimum maximum value determination. So these are the analysis features which is available with the EES. So I was talking about the EES help. So here you can see in this window, there are a number of examples given. Okay. So suppose you want to learn how to carry out the uncertainty analysis for your particular problem. So you open it, entire program is written. Okay. You can formulate your program using that particular text, and easily you can prepare your program. So this help that is very much helpful. So without any physical help from anyone, okay, this the inbuilt help system that is very much convenient. Okay, now let me show you the capability. Suppose you want to solve the nonlinear equations, right? So these are the mathematical equations which are nonlinear in nature. So suppose you want to solve it, okay, you can solve it by substitution of the values. And suppose you are working with any implicit equation, how will you solve it? By the iteration process. So in both the way, it is a very laborious task. But if I want to solve this equation using EES, here in the slide, in the equation window, you can see x square plus y cube is equal to 7. Okay, square root x divided by y square plus 1 is equal to 2, and a plus x is 1.234. Okay, so here are three equations. Okay, you just type it, and what's your syntax? Okay, you are more familiar because most of us have studied the C programming or Fortran. So similar text is used, so it is easy to enter the equation into the equation window. So in this equation window, whatever equation you want to solve, you have to type over here, and you have to make sure that number of equations and number of unknowns, that must be same. Okay, and suppose you are writing 100 equations and you forget that unknowns are 100 or more than 100 or less than 100, so there is a check here, red button, that you can tick button is there. If you press it, it will give you that how many equations you have entered and how many unknowns in that equations. So you can see that both should be same. If both are same, then there is a solve button. You can see here this calculator symbol. So if you solve it in a fraction of a second, it will give you the answer of the unknowns. Okay. So here, any type of equations, okay, you can easily solve. Now, another capability that is built-in function. So here you can see all the mathematic functions that is available over here. Fluid properties, all the fluid properties are available in the library of the EES. Solid liquid properties. In EES library routines, okay, some the uncommon working fluids, okay, their properties are also available over here. So here, whenever whatever property or whatever function you want to call into the program window, okay, you can type or you can select from the functions window, and whatever text over here, you just paste it, that will be pasted into the program window. Okay, I am giving you the example of let's say fluid property. Suppose I want to find out the density of the air. Okay, so for any thermodynamic property, you require at least two values or two state postulate that is required. So I want to find out the density, either you require temperature or pressure, or you require temperature or specific volume, or whatsoever two properties you required. So I am giving temperature T25, pressure P100, and if from the built-in function, the fluid properties, if I select the density, and against that, if I select the working fluid as air, this type of text that you can paste onto the program window. And if you run it, you will get the density at temperature T1 and P1. So this density value that is taken from the library itself. Similarly for the enthalpy. So this function is also available. So again, for finding the enthalpy of any working fluid, you require to state postulate. So enthalpy value. So by this way, if you provide the state postulates, then easily you can find out various property values. Okay. So this function that is unique function into the EES. Okay. So equations can be solved using the MATLAB, but in the MATLAB, this type of inbuilt thermodynamic property is not there. Right. So by this way, any thermodynamic properties you can easily call into the program window. Similarly, solid property that you can call. So is the Young modulus of aluminum. So for solid property, you require one value. Let's say temperature is there. So at 140 degrees Celsius, Young modulus value for the aluminum that will be called from the property table. So up to here, you can understand that how the equations can be written onto the program window, correct? And whatsoever equations we have derived, let's say for vapor absorption system, for exergy destruction, all the equations you can type into the program window, and you can call the enthalpy, entropy, the values, okay, from the property table. Now, parametric study. Now, parametric study is, in essence, the study of the influence of variations in one or more variables onto the solution. Correct. Now, the effect of certain parameters onto the performance that needs to be done many times. So generally, in other softwares, most of the softwares, this task is carried out by forming a loop. Okay. Sometimes to run the loop, okay, it is a tedious job. But here in ES, it accomplishes this very elegantly by using the spreadsheet-like approach. Okay, the way we are using the Excel sheet, similar way, the spreadsheet approach is used in ES to carry out the parametric study. With one example, let us try to understand this. Suppose I want to find out the behavior, or I want to find out the effect of theta onto the y. Correct. As I vary the theta from 0 to 360, what will be the value of y? Correct. So here, I can write this program like this. Theta is equal to 45 degree. Y is equal to cos theta. Okay. So theta is taken over here and y value that will be published. Okay. But it will give you only one for one angle. Suppose I want to find out for 0 to 360. So in that case, in the program window, I'll deactivate the theta is equal to 45 degree because this value I am giving through the spreadsheet. Okay. So the equation is y is equal to cos theta, and I am preparing the spreadsheet like this. So into the menu, table menu. Okay. I'll choose the new parametric table. When I click onto the new parametric table, it will show me the variables into the equations. So there are two variables in the equation, theta and y. Okay. So I want to vary the theta and I want to see the effect onto the y. So I'll add both of it and I can see this type of parametric table. So you will see the two columns. First column is theta, which is the independent variable, and y is a dependent variable. Okay. So if I enter the various values of theta in this table, there are various ways to enter the values in this particular table. First of all, I have to decide the runs, means I would like to vary the theta value from 0 to 360, okay, for 9 values. Okay, so you select the number of runs over here, right? And here in this specified row, either you can copy the values from Excel sheet, which is already available with you, to this parametric table, or you can use this quick fill button. Here you can see this is a quick fill button. I hope you can see this. I mean, this corner, there is a quick fill button. So that quick fill button, if you press it, you can see this window where it shows that you have entered 9 row. How would you like to enter the values? So if you define first value and last value, okay, it will take intermediate values, okay, 9 values. So by this way, by using the quick fill button, you can enter the values of the theta, you can enter the values of independent variables, or you can directly paste the values from the Excel sheet to this, or manually you can enter the value of theta in each and every row. Okay, and here this green button. Okay. So here you can see the table name, and this green button, that is a run button. If you press the green symbol, okay, all the calculated Y values will be displayed. Okay, so here, whatsoever number of runs, okay, within a fraction of a second, you will get the values of the dependent variable. So here I am considering only 2 variables. If you have n variables, okay, then also similar way you can carry out the parametric analysis. Now, whatsoever values, okay, you have calculated, now you want to plot, you want to show it onto the graph. So there is a plot options available. So that is, in engineering equation solver, to prepare a graph is very much easier. And here some steps I have given. So first of all, you have to select the plot type from the menu. Then you have to select the data source for which table. Okay, suppose you have prepared the table 1 for which you want to plot the graph. So you have to select the data source. Then you have to select the axis, okay, for which means a dependent variable and independent variable axis you have to choose, and some plot formatting option that you can see over here. You can define the heading, you can define the line type. Okay, so some plot tools are there. So here the same thing that you can see, this is a plot window. So here you can enter the plot name, you can give the description of the plot for which particular analysis you have shown the characteristics. Now here the parametric table. So it may possible that at a time you are preparing n number of tables, and for particular table you want to show the characteristics. So that table you have to choose over here. So whatsoever table you have prepared, in a scroll down button you can see all the tables. So you have to select the tables. Then you have to select the variable on particular axis. Okay, so generally the independent variable that is on x-axis and dependent variable that is on y-axis. So that you have to choose here. Now for how many runs you would like to show the characteristics on a plot. So number of runs out of 1 to 9, suppose I want to choose only 1 to 5, that is also possible. And here number of options, you may keep it open, spline fade, automatic update. Here automatic update option is very much important, because whenever you change anything in the program, that will be automatically reflected into the graph also, correct? And here the line symbol color, that is, you can choose. Now here minimum maximum value. So sometimes to maintain the aspect ratio of the graph, okay, you have to select the minimum and maximum value and interval in a such a way that the characteristics you would like to represent, okay, that is more convenient, okay, to the user. Okay, now this is the plot, which is from y-axis, y versus theta. Okay, so this type of plot we can produce. Now here we can also overlay the plot. Suppose you have another variable, okay, which is when the theta is changing, some other variables that you would like to show onto this graph. So that overlay facility that is also available. Okay, so this is all about engineering equation solver. Right now I can't show the engineering equation solver software because I do not have access from my home. So I'm not connected with the server of the university, but I have tried to explain you, okay, the capability of the engineering equation solver. Okay, how the engineering equation solver can be used to solve the equations. What are the, there are lots of features, but right now whatever features that is essential to show the analysis of vapor absorption system that I have shown to you. So here in the back to the simulation process, so these are the assumptions which we have considered for analyzing the absorption cooling. I am considering LiCl H2O pair, and I am considering the initial conditions as 1 TR cooling capacity. I would like to analyze the cooling system for 1 TR cooling load. I am considering the generator temperature at 78 degrees Celsius, absorber temperature is 40 degrees Celsius, condenser temperature is 36 degrees Celsius, evaporator as 10 degrees Celsius, and I am assuming the solution heat exchanger effectiveness is 0.7. So with this initial conditions, if I analyze, I'll get the values of enthalpy and entropy and mass flow rate, concentration and temperature at various state points. So from state point 1 to 18, I'll have all the values. Now this table that can be used to apply the exergy analysis or exergy balance across each and every component. And if I do it, I can find out the exergy destruction across various components. So here you can see for generator, exergy destruction is 0.1558 kilowatt. Similar way in other components also. The last column you can see the non-dimensional exergy loss, which shows the percentage of total exergy loss of the cycle. So in a generator, 27.77% of total exergy loss that is occurred. In absorber, 36.31%. So likewise, if you observe it, maximum exergy destruction that is found in absorber and generator. So through this analysis, you can identify the exergy destruction. Exergy destruction that is that directly reflects the irreversibility present in particular component. Okay. So more is the exergy destruction, less efficient that component is. Correct. So if that exergy destruction is minimized, then the overall performance of the system is to be overall system performance of the system can be improved. Okay, so through this analysis, at least we can identify the exergy destruction, identify the exergy losses in various components, correct? And from this, which component needs to be focused? So whatever the component which is having more exergy destruction, it is obvious to focus for the improvement of performance of entire system. Okay, suppose here the pump, for the pump the exergy destruction is very very less. So if you replace the pump to improve the performance, okay, then it will not give any actual performance improvement. Okay, rather than if you do something with the generator or absorber, okay, then definitely it will give the improvement into the performance. So through this analysis, we can at least identify. Now this calculation is for one operating parameters, one operating set, okay, which I have considered. Now if I change operating parameters, let's say if I change the generator temperature, correct? So generator temperature, let's say I'm varying from 76 to 83. So in that case, how the exergy destruction takes place in various components, how it variation, okay, with respect to generator temperature, that you can see in the plot. So this is a total exergy destruction. So this line, this brown line that shows the total exergy destruction, but total axial distraction remains almost constant, but axial distraction in individual component varies with respect to the generator temperature. So this type of behavior, okay, that you can see through this parametric study. Similarly, condenser temperature, as we vary the condenser temperature, how the axial distraction varies in various components. Similarly, effect of the evaporator temperature, effect of the absorber temperature. And here, the temperature range in a particular component needs to be maintained to achieve the maximum exergetic efficiency. Let's say for evaporator, if the evaporator is operating, let's say at 6 to 7 degrees Celsius, okay, then it will give the maximum exergy efficiency. Similarly for generator, if it is operating at, let's say 73-74 degrees Celsius, okay, it will give maximum exergetic efficiency. So by this way, through this parametric analysis, we can say that which operating conditions are best suitable for particular components. Correct. So this is a analysis of very simple thermodynamic cycle of absorption cooling. It is a single effect. Similarly, you can do it for double effect. Correct. Now here I have used the working pair as LiCl H2O. If you use LiBr H2O, then for the same operating conditions, okay, you have to write down the material name as LiCl H2O in place of LiBr H2O in place of LiCl H2O. Okay, and entire thing that will be simulated, and you can compare the COP, you can compare the exergetic efficiency in various components, okay, when you change the working pair, right? So nowadays, LiBr H2O, that is mostly used pair into the industries of the vapor absorption cooling. But now people are in search of the other alternatives. Okay, which are the other alternative possible? Because nowadays lithium is also used into the batteries. So tomorrow definitely the cost of lithium will definitely increase. So people are in search of another working pairs which gives more improved thermodynamic performance. So in that case, for initial phase analysis, okay, this type of practices that is really helpful. So here the conclusion of this particular analysis, that you can see 73 degrees Celsius is the maximum exergetic efficiency, and 6 degree, that is the minimum evaporator temperature that is possible. Okay, or if you operate this system at this particular operating temperature, it gives the maximum exergetic efficiency or second efficiency, right? Now, what we have done with this, we have started this practice in 2017, and we have published one paper, that is exergy-based analysis of LiCl H2 absorption cooling system. Now, with this experience, we have started to work on various working pairs, let's say aqua ammonia, okay, and we got the good results. Then we have worked on the another working pair, let's say aqua ammonia, apart from aqua ammonia, NS3 sodium thiocyanate and ammonia and lithium nitrate. These are the newly developed working pairs. Okay, some of the research groups are already working on it. So how it behaves, okay, when I consider this working pair, okay, what is the thermodynamic performance? Okay, what are the limitations of this working pair? Okay, that we can address. So here, by this way, with the span of 3 to 3.5 years, okay, more than 13 publications, okay, that is the outcome of this EES exercise. Okay, so I learned the EES in 2016-17, and along with my students, MTech students, okay, we have published number of papers. Now, for these publications, okay, no single experiment was made. Without any experiment, okay, using the thermodynamic analysis, okay, these publications are possible. Okay, in our MTech thermal engineering, okay, number of students are working with the EES. So when the students enter into the first semester, okay, students are taught the engineering equation solver as a part of their regular course. Then regularly students are means using this EES for their particular thermal problems. And this is this list that is only of my students. Similar list that is available for other faculty members which are also working on EES. So through this EES platform, okay, so the thermal analysis, okay, which is otherwise very complex in nature, okay, that becomes easier. And this is the outcome that you can see in the slide. So this is all I would like to share with you, that equation solver, introduction of equation solver, then how this equation solver can be used, okay, for various thermodynamic calculations, and what is the outcome of this knowledge of EES. Okay, that's all I have presented. So I am very much thankful to the audience. Now, any questions, you please ask.
Yes, thank you, sir. There is one question from Vijay Kalidas.
Yes.
Why vapor absorption chiller fails?
Hmm. Why?
Vapor absorption chiller fails.
I'm not getting. Ruchir, sir, please repeat the question. Why absorption chillers fails?
Yes. I hope that they want to ask the reason behind the failures of absorption chiller.
Okay. Now see, the absorption system, the work, if you see the working, that is very much complex, correct? So whenever you want to work with the vapor absorption system, the working temperature range is very narrow. Let's say in our simulation also, we have seen that the generator temperature is varying from 73 to, let's say, up to 76 or 77. Okay. So if the operating temperature is not in this range, then definitely there are the problems of crystallization, and to recrystallize, recrystallization problems are there, and to overcome that problem, okay, lots of time is required. So whenever we want to work with any absorption system, okay, the control aspect is very much essential. So that's why through this type of analysis, we can define the range of operating parameters for which that particular component needs to be operated. Okay, if we have that knowledge, then if we can maintain that particular conditions, there will not have any problem in the vapor absorption system. But whatsoever vapor absorption system problems are occur nowadays, that is due to the lack of this control. Correct. So this type of analysis definitely that will address, okay, these problems. To overcome these problems, okay, for any working pair, okay, easily we can define the operating temperatures. Yes.
Any other questions from the audience? Simply, we are receiving the response that the nice presentation, nice PPT. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you. Thank you.
They are also asking for the today's recording for their reference for how to solve this, how to use this engineering equation solver software.
Sure, sure. So actually, it is my...
Sir, we will provide the presentation, a whole recording to that student.
Correct, correct, correct. And I am thankful to ISRE chapter for giving me such a nice platform so I can interact with the interested participants today. So again, I am thankful.
So
ISRE chapter.
Any other questions? No, okay. So before the vote of thanks, I want to share something for the students. Dear students, kindly renew your membership to avail the benefits, continuous benefit of ISRE. To renew your membership, please click on the www.ishrehq.in. For any query regarding to membership or any questions regarding to your memberships, you can call us, or even you can drop a mail to ishreahd@gmail.com. Thank you, students. Jatin sir, thank you very much for your today's great fruitful session on the analysis of absorption cooling system. we also got some basic concept, basic fundamental to how to use these engineering equation solvers. And with the help of that software, without experiment, how can we publish a paper? It is also, we are also getting the such information from this presentation. Thank you very much, sir, for your great, valuable time.
Thank you, Ruchir sir. Thank you, Hardik sir. Thank you, Rajendra bhai.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Okay.
Okay. Bye.
Dear Sneh. Sneh, are you here?
Yes, Rajendra.
Please, meeting off, kar de, dear.
Okay.